Hi again, you guys. Welcome to another edition of Curtis Collects Vinyl Records. This is a band called Mountain, and they're rather significant in American rock and roll. And before we get into that, let me start off by saying thank you for your patience. It's been a couple of months. I know I skipped January and February. Here we are in March, and I'm really sorry about that, but things happen. Life happens. Other things happen. And just needed to get back into the swing of things, and I know some of you guys were out there clamoring, what's happened, what's going on with your program, here we are, where it's all good, but glad to be back here in the record room. So let's dive right into it. So Mountain, I was on a trip recently, I was on an airplane, I have my new headphones, and I was sampling a playlist that is provided by the airline, plugged them in, saw this set list by Mountain, and I was like, wow, that's really interesting. Of course I know a little bit about Mountain. Couple of things. One, they played at Woodstock. Two, a lot of people think they sort of kind of were the forefathers of American heavy metal. To me, they sound a lot like some version of a Led Zeppelin with a lot of shades and light soft edges and hard edges, and a song like that reminds me of something that might be from Led Zeppelin IV. So beautiful. So, of course, they were Leslie West. They had that great song that kind of put them on the map, Mississippi Queen. And before we play, this is going to be a twofer. So that song we just played is a 3.5-minute song performed and sung and written by Leslie West to my friend. And that's going to go right into The Laird, which we're going to play right after that from this album called Climbing or Mountain Climbing. I give them really high marks for their creativity. Their album covers are really what we would have called groundbreaking back in the day. And they're on this interesting Windfall label, which is, I think, a unit of Columbia. Great, so let's go through the rest of the records that I have by Mountain in my collection. That's usually how it works. This is called Nantucket Sleigh Ride. Really beautiful album cover. Just let's take a moment and look at that. This was just fabulous, and I love... Oh, so not only did they have Leslie West, but Felix Pappalardi went on and was a producer for, I think, one of the great albums or a couple of albums by Cream. So he kind of went from being the bass player and the guy in this band onto a production career. Beautiful. This is Mountain, Flowers of Evil. This is great. So Steve Knight is on here, Leslie West, Felix Pappalardi, and Corky Lang. Here is Mountain, Avalanche. Pretty much the standard lineup. Trying to look at the back of this. Okay, fabulous. And here is Twin Peaks, another gorgeous record cover. I think this was half live, half studio. It's a double album. Again, fabulous artwork. You guys probably know below who is the artist on these. I should know that. I'll let you guys use the comments down below for that. That's always fun. Yeah, so this is, I think, live and some studio work in it. So let's go into this next song. It's the one I really found that I liked on that playlist that I listened to. It's called The Laird, and it's following right now. Here we go.
Thank you.
hey, I'm still pretty okay at this. So I like doing that at the end when we just kind of go back through the reverse order of the records I just showed you guys. I think that's a nice touch and it seemed to work out. So if you're new here, this is how it works. Not an expert, I'm a fan. Don't need to say that too many times, but this is a pretty standard way we do things down here in the record room. Use the comments down below, and most importantly, thanks for your patience. I'm going to knock out a few more of these so we can keep the momentum going down here in the record room. So once again, thanks for watching, thanks for listening. This was another edition of Curtis Collects Vinyl Records.